Okay, good afternoon. In the yesterday's class, we have discussed some examples, and last example you should focus on it. What it says? It says about something about the linear combination of vectors, that the vectors of the form AU plus BV, where U and V are the vectors and A and V are the scalars, that you are taking combination and verify that W set is subspace. One more example we'll see. That we will not cover in the yesterday class, and then we'll define what do you mean by linear combination, and later we'll see the linear span and some example, and if time permits then we'll show some results also here. Okay, I will share screen here. Once screen is shared, you can off your videos. But I will call any one of you at one time. Otherwise, you will off your video and move here and there. It will not permit. There is not permission. Huh? I may ask somebody. And he should answer immediately in the meeting. Okay. This is the example that we want to discuss, because this type of example will come so many times in near future also. So, here. Now consider the system of homogeneous equations. Your W set is all those x satisfying Ax equal to 0. Now think where this x can from. So you have mentioned that this A is with m rows. How m rows? Because there are m linear equations and n columns. Because n unknowns are there. So what are the unknowns? X1, X2, Xn. So your X matrix will be written in column form. X1, X2, Xn. So where it belongs to? Since it is n tuple, X1, X2, Xn are the real numbers. So it is always belongs to Rn. So this is always subset of Rn. So that we want to show, first verify that this is non-empty. Now since it is homogeneous system of equations, we know if there is always guaranteed solution, and one solution is there, that is one can take x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, and so on, xn equal to 0. That is x equal to 0 vector, 0 column with n rows, such that what is value of ax? A into 0 gives 0. So dusre kodi asu nako, but 0 column is a solution of this Ax equal to 0. For homogeneous system is always consistent. You have seen your UMAT 136 algebra paper, the last unit, how the homogeneous system is always consistent, that we have seen. So 0 vector, the 0 vector of n tuple 0, write in column form, is always solution to Ax equal to 0. So 0 belongs to there. So I call it as 0 bar. 0 bar as 0, 0, 0. N tuple 0, it is belongs to W. So in this way, W is non-empty subset. Once it is non-empty, we can have elements there. X1 and X2. In that set W, I write W here. What is W? All those X, n tuple X, write in column form, such that Ax equal to 0. And this is always a subset of Rn. Rn is a vector space that we already checked. Only we need to check that this W is subspace of this. And to show subspace, you show it is non-empty. It is closed under additions and scalar multiplication also. So alpha is any scalar. Here scalar means always a real number. Throughout this course, we are assuming as real number, unless or until it is mentioned. So first, second condition you are checking after non-empty. Second condition is addition is closed. So your target is x1 plus x2 must be in W. When x1 plus x2 is in W, if it is solution. Who is writing on the screen? Okay. X1 plus X2 belongs to W. This is our target here. So how it becomes? You must have A into X1 plus X2 0. So it will become AX1, AX2 as a property of matrix. And what is AX1? It is 0. What is AX2? It is 0 because X1 belongs to W. X1 belongs to W means AX1 is 0. Similarly, X2 belongs to W means AX2 is 0. So that's why this is 0. It's actual 0 vector. So in this way, X1 plus X2 is also solution to AX equal to 0. So it belongs to W for every X1 comma X2 in W. So here, addition is closed, and last conditions we need to verify is that. What is the last condition? That we need to show that it is the scalar multiplication is closed. So you have to choose this alpha as a scalar and take X1. X1 or X2, any you take. And you want to show that in the second conditions, you want to show that second condition claim is alpha times X1 belongs to W. So let us show that alpha X1 is solution to X equal to 0. So here you get alpha as a scalar multiplication property in matrix multiplication. You can move alpha anywhere, scalar anywhere, and you know it is 0. Since X1 belongs to W. X1 belongs to W means AX1 is a 0 vector. So in this way it becomes 0. So thus alpha X1 is also solution to AX equal to 0 for every scalar and X1 in W. Scalar from field F. So in this way, three conditions holds. The W, this W is non-empty because 0 is there. And once it is non-empty, you can have any two elements and any scalar in the field F and verify these two conditions, and that it is show that the set of all solutions of system of this linear equation is a subset of Rn. Why Rn? Because X is n tuple vector. It is written in the column form. That also keep in mind. So this is example. Now we'll define linear combination. This is important part of linear algebra. This type of concept come many times. What do you mean by linear combinations? As we have seen yesterday's example, that W is written as vectors of the form AU plus BV. What are the A and B? A and B are the scalars. And for any U and V, in vector space V. So this is just combination of U and V. This is called combination of U and V. Linear combination of U and V, two vectors. So that that concept can be generalized here. Suppose V bar is a vector in V. And if V bar is, here every vector in W is linear combination of this. And I am saying particular V bar in vector V. Any vector V in V, no need to write bar also. But for understanding, we'll write sometime. We say that V bar is a linear combination of V1 and V2 here if it is written as like this. If this V bar is K1 V1 bar plus K2 V2 bar and so on, Kn Vn bar. If this V is written as not capital V, one vector, it's just one vector of V. One vector of V is written likewise. Suppose I say 1, 2, 3. I can say it is linear combination of, suppose I take two vectors 1, 2, 0 and 0, 0, 1. So this can be written as linear combination of two vectors. So here scalar will be 1 and here scalar will be 3, and just find the addition. What is addition? It is just addition of these two. So this 1, 2, 3 is linear combination of these two. 1, 2, 3 is linear combination of these two vectors. So you may call it as V1 bar, you may call it as V2 bar, and this is your vector V. So V bar is linear combination of these two vectors. Here scalar is 1 and here scalar is 3. Because this is, you call this as V1, this as V2 and this as V1, and scalars are 1, 3. So we'll see more example for this. What do you mean by linear combination? So if you have any difficulty, please ask in the chat box. Chat box madhe mention kara kai difficulty asal tar. We can be written as linear combination of these vectors. Just by example, we can clear it. I think no difficulty. Now we'll see this definition later. For that we'll have example. Read this example carefully. Your vector space is R3. R3 means three triplet vectors, and the triplets bits are from real number. What is V1? V1 is 1, 2, 3. V2 is, I will not use bar notation here. You can understand who is vector and who is scalar. Be any two vectors in this V. So what is the first part? First part we want to show that -1, -4, and 1. This term is a linear combination of, you have to find A and B here. What are A and B to get this number? And you can, we know how to solve such type of system of equations. So what equation we get here? A into V1 is -1. V1 is not -1. V1 is 1, 2, 3. And V2 is 0, minus 1, 2. Sritipad asks, is scalar K is from field only? Yeah, scalars are from field. When you write, okay, Suraj won't have answered it. You find scalars -1 and 2, okay. See, whenever you write the terms like this, A into U, K into V, in vector, we do not write multiplication. We have to treat one as scalar. So as we have defined the scalar product as F cross V, to V. A scalar product is from F cross V to V. So field element, always have first position here, whatever you write, and the vectors are always this. But in some book, they don't use the bar notations. Bar doesn't mean that you are creating your physical vectors also. You may have four-dimensional, n-dimensional, or matrix as a vector. So that's why. So you have to solve this system of equations. So how A2A, this is definition of scalar multiplication in R3. 0 into B, 0 into minus 1 into B, and 2 into B. So after addition, I will get A plus 0, second 2A minus B, and third 3A plus 2B. So what is it? It is actually equal to -1. 2a minus b is 4. And this is 1. You have to solve it for a and b. So directly you get value of a as -1 here. Once you get value of a as -1, just comparing two points are equal. When this, because you are writing equal to this. So by the equality definition, a has to be -1. Once you get a equal to -1, 2a minus b implies, V a minus B is 2. A is minus 1, so what is value of B? Somebody has mentioned in the chat box, A is minus 1, so value of B is, what was that value? I think B becomes 4. A is, if A is minus 1, then B becomes 4. Is it? Minus B equal to plus 4. B becomes minus 4, I think. Just solve it and tell me the answer. Okay, it's coming to. Okay, you have to write, the second point is 2A minus B is minus 4. So I will erase it first. Okay, here 2A minus B is minus 4 and value of A is minus 1. So B becomes B becomes 2, I think. And check that whether it satisfies 3 into minus 1 and 3 into 2. So it is 1. So it verifies that whatever you find A and B, it must satisfy all three equations, all three conditions. Your 3A plus 2B has to win for find, you have find A and B here. So 3A, in if you put A equal to minus 1 and B equal to 2 here, it gives 1. So I will write here, you can say that minus 1, minus 4, 1. Is written as value of A was minus 1 into V1 and value of B was 2 into V2. If you calculate this, means these are the scalars. This is the first scalar, second scalar. K1 is minus 1 and K2 is 2. So in this way, 1 minus 4, 1 is written as linear combination of U1 into this A part is verified here. Minus 1 minus 4, 1 is a linear combination of V1 and V2. We'll go for second. Now it is not linear combination, means we cannot find A and B satisfying this. So we cannot find, means system has to be inconsistent in that case, or all three points will not be satisfied. So A into V1 plus B into V2, you write it as 4, 7, 15. So what is A? What is V1? V1 is 1, 2, 3. A, new way we want to find it. And B also we need to find. But we cannot find here, that we want to prove. If we are not able to find, means it is not linear combination. So after calculation, I will write directly here 2A plus 0. Not 2A. It has to be A plus B into two. Next is two, next coordinate is 2A, 2A minus B. And the coordinates we have found already. And next coordinate is, it is 3A, 3A plus 2B. This is equal to 4, 7 and 15. So you are writing A equal to 4, 2A minus B equal to 7, and 3A plus 2B equal to 15. You can find value of B from here and show that this A and B doesn't satisfy this. So can anybody tell that value, what is value of B? B is 2A minus 7. I move this B here and 7 here. So what is that? 2 into 4. So it is 1. So does it satisfy? You just check it. 3 into 4 plus 2 into 1 is 14 plus 2, 14. It is not equal to 15. it doesn't satisfy. So we cannot find A and B. Consist upon the linear system lily, three inconsistent. A and B does not satisfy the third point. The 15 average 14 as the okay with. So whatever A and B you find, it will not work for the point. So we are not able to find A and B. We are not able to find A and B means we cannot write 4, 7, 15 this point as a linear combination of your V1 and V2. I think it is clear to everyone. We have another example. This is AGS example that okay, this is x equal to real line and y is also real line, and this is your R2, plane R2, and on x-axis you are taking this point as 1, 0, and on y-axis with the same distance you take point 0, 1, and we want to show that every point on this plane is a linear combination of this. So you take any point x, y, be any point or any vector in R2, and how the x and y is written, easily one can say that x and y can be written as the sum of two vectors, that is x, 0 plus 0, y, the first step. And you need to find scalar. It is x into 1, 0 plus y into 0, 1. So x and y are the required real number. So your a is x and b is y. So it is x into v1 plus y into v2 gives every vector xy. So whatever xy, whatever a, b you choose, everybody can be written as the linear combination of these points. So everyone is written as the linear combination of these two, not this. Suppose you are writing 2, 3. How 2, 3 is done? 2 into v1 plus 3 into v2. Suppose you are writing e, pi. E and pi are also real numbers, so e pi also belongs to R2. So it is e v1, e is a scalar, and pi is also scalar because they are real number. So like this, every point in this plane is a linear combination of this v1 and v2. Every point in this plane is linear combination of this v1 and v2. Can somebody find any point other than this? Are there only these two points, right? Can somebody find the points other than this? There are any other points satisfying the same conditions? I will write these two points. Can every vector is linear combination of these two? Then it is solvable for. Can you find A and B for any X and Y? Yep. X and Y are known, and unknowns are A and B. So how one can find? You must get X here. You have to write value of A such that and B such that you may get X and Y here. So it is A and A plus B is x, y. So value of A is x and value of B is y minus x. So you can see x into 1, 1 and y minus x into 0, 1. Just calculate it and find it. So it is x comma y always. So this is also another point. Which point? 10 and 11. These are the two vectors. These two vectors also, for these two vectors also, we can show that every vector in R2 is linear combination of these two vectors. And there are many more such type of vectors, not only these two. We have, can have any two. Now I will give trick here. When you write point, see here, we know the consistence and inconsistence. So I will show how one can find all those points, all different points here. So I will erase it, and you need to solve the system of equations in the variable. These x and y are not variable. A and b you need to calculate. So that's why they are variable. So a equal to x is the first equation. So a plus 0b equal to x. This is the first equation. And next equation is a plus b is y. And in a matrix form, you can write it as 1, 0, 1, 1. And your unknowns a comma b and equal to please mark your attendance equal to x comma y. A and b we need to find. So in the first year you have seen that 1 0 1 1, the augmented matrix x comma y. You need to find solution for this. And where it is solutions? Now this is square system. You just find out the determinant. If determinant is zero, then it is no singular matrix and we are not able to solve non-homogeneous system. Homogeneous system always can be solved. Homogeneous system always can be solved. If determinant is zero, means whatever point you write. Suppose your point is first point is a1b1 and second point is a2b2. You just write in determinant form. What is the first point? a1b1 as a column, and second point a2b2. If this determinant is non-zero, there and then these two points, for regarding these two points, we can say every vector in R2 is a linear combination of these two points, otherwise not. Now, for example, suppose I will take two vectors 1, 1 and 2, 2. It is, these two vectors will, every vector in R2 will not be in the combination of these two. So, if we observe that 2, 2 is 1, 1 multiple, determinant card is 0, 2, 2 is multiple of 1, 1. So, if you take 1, 2, we cannot express this 1, 2 is linear combination of these two. So, not every vector can be written. अशा वेक्टरला पुढे बेसिस म्हणतात. अशा वेक्टर्सला पुढे काय म्हणतात? त्या वेक्टर स्पेसचं बेसिस म्हणतात. बेसिस थोडं वेगळ्या भाषेमध्ये डिफाईन करणार आपण. लिनियरली इंडिपेंडेंट आणि ते वेक्टर स्पेसला स्पॅन करते. स्पॅन करते म्हणजे काय? आपण तेही पाहिलेलं नाही. आणि लिनियरली इंडिपेंडेंट काय आपल्याला तेही माहिती आहे. फक्त लक्षात असू द्या, लिस्ट ऑफ वेक्टर्स. सो सच एव्हरी वेक्टर इन दिस वेक्टर स्पेस इज रिटन एज लिनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस टू. दॅट टर्म इज कॉल्ड स्पॅन्स. म्हणजे जर दिस टू वेक्टर्स स्पॅन्स आर टू. These two vectors spans R2 means every vector in R2 is linear combination of these two vectors. That concept you can see. Okay, if you have one more example, then we'll see. Okay, we have one more example. Can you try this example? We have 7 minutes. We can also solve here. We want to show that this 3, 2, 1 is linear. In fact, not 2, 3, 1. Every vector in R3 is linear combination, just 3, 2, 1 is representative of this. We want to show that 3, 2, 1. This vector is linear combination of U. Okay, I use italic notations for the scalars. And we must able to find alpha, beta, and gamma. So alpha into U is 111. Beta into phi is 110. And gamma into W is 100. So this is alpha, comma, alpha scalar multiplication definition. This is beta, comma, 0. And this is gamma, 0, 0. So it is equal to alpha plus beta plus gamma. By the addition definition in R3, second component becomes alpha plus beta plus 0. So it is alpha plus beta plus 0. And third is alpha plus 0 plus 0. So equality definition in vector space Rn or R3, it implies that alpha plus beta plus gamma is 3. Alpha plus beta is 2. And last equation tells us that it is directly standard form. Last equation tells us that alpha is 1. If alpha is 1, what is beta? Beta is also 1. If alpha beta is 1, what is gamma? Gamma is also 1. So in this way, 3, 2, 1 is written as 1. Solution is 1, 1, 1. 3, 2, 1 is written as 1 into triple 1, 1 into double 1, 0, and 1 into 0, 0, 1. So you can check. Now question I may ask, can every vector in R3 linear combination of these three vectors? And its answer is true. Instead of this 3, 2, 1, you can take any ABC. ABC or XYZ. ABC can be any number. Can this is written as linear combination of this? That means you are showing that every vector in R3, every vector in R3 is a linear combination of U, V, W. That we need to check. So this also simplest example. If you find any difficulty, please mention in the chat or raise your hand. If I am unable to see the chat, the people are marking their attendance. Somebody has left after the marking the attendance. And I can sort out who had left. Anyway. Okay, we'll see more example. Just clean it. Okay, we'll recall that definition. We have 3 minutes to see here. Here, linear span of S is defined. Linear span of S is defined. What it means, if S is a set of vectors V1 bar, V2 bar, no need to write bar, okay, but I have written here, with a subset of vector space V. And if you are writing set up all the linear combination of these vectors, set up all the linear combination of these vectors means K1 into V1 bar plus K2 into V2 bar plus and so on. Kr into Vr bar, where all are the scalars. The set of all linear combination of these vectors V1, V2, Vr is called a linear span of the set S. Now in the yesterday's example, we have seen that W is linear combination of U, comma U and V, where A and B are the field elements. Here one can say that it is a linear span of U, comma V. And that is a subspace. Here also in the theorem we have to prove that a linear span of any set of vectors is always subspace of V. So just whatever set it becomes, that we need to find later on. But whatever set you write, this is the notations. K1 V1 plus K2 V2 plus Kr Vr. All the elements are of this form in this set. Every element which is written in this form, which are linear combination of these vectors, will be a part of this W. And then W is called as a span of set S. This, if you call this set as W, then W is called as span of S. Here instead of LS space, one may write W is called as span of S. Now in the earlier example, your V was R2, and suppose if your set is V1 equal to 1, 0 and v2 equal to 0, 1. So what is yellow? Yes. Can anybody put in the chat box? What is the linear combination of these vectors? Who are the vectors which are written as linear combination of these two? Mention in the chat. I am saying that all the linear combination of u and v2, and we have verified that every vector in that is linear combination of this, means it is R2. It is R2. Okay. Similarly, one can say that the linear span of 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. We also verified that these spans are two. Every vector in R2 is linear combination of this. As a linear combination, everybody is subset of R2, but we need to show that every vector in R2 is linear combination of these two. So this is equal to R2. So this means that this set S spans R2, or here S spans W. Put your video on, and if you find any difficulty, please mention in the chat. We have less than 1 minute time now.